And welcome back to YouTube channel Master Sopster. We do have a guest who was kind enough to bring this awesome game here. And the channel's name is...
AG Vask.
And now we're going to play some Street Fighter. This is my very first time playing Street Fighter V. I know I'm late, but just enjoy the damn show.
Alright. Ready? Fight!
Alright, so I press the... I guess this button to proceed.
Woo! Yeah, you have to go in as Vasquez.
Vasquez.
Yeah. Alright. So.
Which is the basic shit? A?
Yeah, A is the default.
Alright, cool. Proceed.
Three, five matches as well.
Let's keep it traditional.
Three?
Yeah. But don't go easy on me. I did play the previous Street Fighters before this. I know in Xenoverse I'm okay, but this game in Street Fighter, I'm just a little bit more tapped in.
Alright. Let's get started. Go for the P2. PP2.
Tune in. YouTube channel, Master Sops.
Alright,
there's no guy here? No, no guy?
No guy.
At least I got Ken.
That's a freaking relief for me.
It's not a relief for me, but it's okay. We can get some Street Fighter 4 after this, too.
Chun-Li.
Let's begin.
Ken is... no other... Oh, I guess I ain't got much choices but to choose that one.
Yeah, they didn't release all the costumes as of yet. I'm surprised I even have Chun-Li's. Maybe it's because I did the story mode. I don't know.
So I have range, a little bit of... Oh, I didn't get to see much of that one. She looks a little different. Size as wide as ever, not complaining, but I think she grew a little bit of a tush there.
I could go with that.
Not complaining either. Alright, let's do it. Crap. Just say it's beginner's luck. It's my first time playing.
Right. With a Shoto.
Well, they don't got guy. Hope they don't charge us like $10 just to have him as a playable character.
Well, this game actually has a system where you earn currency and you can actually buy the characters when they come out. Like with the currency instead of having to pay your money with it.
Whose idea was that? Was that actually Capcom or was that PS4?
Probably.
Well, in that case, that's an upgrade.
I mean, it's good that they brought that system like that, because not everybody has to have to pay for all the characters. And that also, you know, creates a separation between, buyers and non-buyers.
Holy crap, I got triggers and EX that I barely been touching. But that also makes the game a little bit more traditional. Like, you know, you used to have to work to unlock the characters rather than just buy it.
Yeah. Which is a cool little system that they did there, and they encouraged you to play more.
I hear you can parry in this game.
Right now, with the only ones I can think of that have something like that is Ryu and Zangief. It's their V-ism. Basically, V-ism is a skill that's given to each character. It's a unique skill, like, so everyone's V-ism is not going to be the same. Like, Ken's V-ism may be the dash, Chun-Li's is to do this weird jump thing. This right here, that's her V-ism.
Oh, defeat! Profound sadness!
profound happiness for me. But
bend over, Chun-Li. She did it.
I love this card.
You saying?
I love it.
Oh.
I love it a lot. Alright. See what other options we
so have. I wonder, I see Ken is not too different, familiar enough for me to play with, as you can see. This is the very first time I played this game. But I'm curious if Ryu changed at all or.
Well, yeah, they all have their subtle changes. I think Ken was a big departure, though, from his previous counterparts. And he's a lot more rushed down, in my experience. His realism also kind of gives him room for closing in distance, and he could also cancel into other moves, which is actually pretty fun. But I find him to be a good change. I think they made a pretty big change with Dalsim, mostly with his projectiles. Speed-wise, he's the same for the most part, but outside of that, it gives him a tactical change.
Something about this girl just tells me to pick her. Maybe the boobies, the pose. Eh. She looks like they took like Sean and just said, fuck it, let's make him into a girl. Let's take a girl and just like make her awesome.
Funny you mention that, because that's actually his sister.
Well, it's worth playing with. Is she also trained by Ken? Is that disclosed at all in the game?
No, that hasn't been mentioned at all. It doesn't even seem like Sean's being trained by Ken yet either. This does take place before Street Fighter 3, so I'm gonna guess that this is like he hasn't met him yet or something. Or maybe they bring him in some DLC and that kind of, well, they may shed light on that too. I don't know.
That's crazy. Well, see what she got. Other than what we see.
Yeah, she's got plenty to show. Not that I'm complaining or anything. Karen, she's introduced now in three.
Electricity.
She has an interesting style. She's been playing with Sakura, which I'm honestly surprised that she didn't make her appearance in this game. I mean, there's always room for her to appear in as DLC, but just kind of weird that you put her in just straight out. But then they put this girl in.
You know, now that you mentioned that, Mikado, she feels very similar in terms of dashing. Maybe a little bit more aerial. Oh, I'm sorry, you said Sakura. I'm thinking about Makoto. She reminds me of Makoto a bit.
Yeah, Makoto, you know, she was in Street Fighter 3 as well, so there's a chance that she can make her way in here as well.
Ouch. So, I'm taking she does a little bit of, what's the style of that martial arts again?
Capoeira,
like Eddie from what game was that, Tekken?
Yeah, Tekken. Well, it's not exactly capoeira. I think it's a form of jiu-jitsu that she does. I'm not entirely clear of the style, but it's a more grappling, grappling-based fighting style.
And if you're watching, please be sure to comment. Let us know, because I'd like to know.
Trust me.
Ooh, that hurt. I just want to feel that.
Yeah.
Ouch!
Physics, one step at a time.
Wow. So I'm guessing she does Aikido to an extent or something like that.
Probably. What I really like about this game is that, you know, I feel like it goes back to the basics. I think it feels more closer to the original Street Fighters. And it's going to be in a playstyle than even the last one. I feel like because of the focus system, Street Fighter 4 is going to be a little too technical. And you kind of stray from what, at least from what I remember, Street Fighter 4. I appreciate this more because it's less about, you know, complex combos, though the complex combos are still there. It still can be played like a basic Street Fighter game for casual people to come in and enjoy.
Wow. Well, I'm enjoying it. So far, so good. I mean, I am a little hurt that Guy's not currently the playable character. But let's see what these other characters have in store. I'm curious.
Yeah, we'll see. I mean, we got a whole roster ahead of us. I mean, they've already confirmed the first five. As like the first one right now is currently available. This guy Alex, he's supposed to be one of the DLC characters. They gave him out free to people to test him out. I mean, once the store opens up, it's gonna be perfect. You're gonna have to buy him for about 100,000 fight money.
So it's kind of like Marvel vs. Capcom 2 when it first came out, to an extent.
Well, yeah, well, you have to buy the characters and buy all the content, yeah. Only that you have the option to buy it with real money as well.
Well, yeah. let's avoid that option right now.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm just saying, for those who don't want to work for a while.
If you want a shortcut, just pull out your wallet and just buy it. See, now I see we got Charlie back. He looks a little zombified.
Well, you know, a couple of years in death, I can kind of do that.
So, hold on. You told me Gal's not in this game?
He's not in there yet. He's actually going to be brought in as DLC. He's one of the, I believe, one of the five confirmed characters. I mean, I could be wrong. You can correct me.
Hold on. What the fuck is up? I have no blade kick? Oh, there you go.
Yeah, it just doesn't work the same way.
So it's actually Hurricane Kick. I'm not complaining, it just feels different from what I'm used to.
Well, you'll learn that in this game, they changed up a lot of people's moves and simplified it to just a simple motion. Even the specials. Almost everybody's special move is either some kind of Hadouken, half circle motion, or three-dimensional 360s. But there really aren't as many charged
Jesus
supers
Christ,
in this
Christ, I'm sorry, I'm just receiving that devastating blow. I felt like I was crucified in the air for a bit and then slammed.
So that's kind of the effect that it has on people.
Hold on, no perfect, can't allow that.
That's okay.
How dare you?
I'll take an overwhelming victory.
So, what was he doing right there?
I think he was just doing squats there. Or something.
I'm still trying to figure it out. Maybe that's his little victory dance.
Could be.
So, is Dudley coming back to Street Fighter?
Well, he wasn't confirmed yet. And, I think the only ones that they've confirmed was, of course, Alex, as you can see. Ibuki is supposed to be making a comeback. I think Elena was supposed to be one of them. Guy, Urien.
Was that Urien?
Urien from Street Fighter 3.
Oh.
That was Gil's brother.
I see. So, this guy kind of reminds me of Rolento. He probably moves nothing like him. Kind of pulls like Strider a bit, but I think I'll select him.
He's actually a pretty cool character. He's got a multi-game attack, he's very agile.
You got the Strider colors right there. Is that a scouter on his eye? Can you read your power level or something?
That would be cool if you could. I'm not quite sure what it is, to be frank. It does look like a scouter.
He has a backpack?
This is the path of my destiny. I am receiving the tribute win. Remember the name well. Round one. Fight.
Oh, he reminds me of Fei Long now for some reason. The stance.
A little bit, yeah. I mean, he's not going to have his fighting style.
But he, what was his name? I think El Fuerte?
Yeah.
Kind of reminds me of his movements also, like a blend of the two. But if you ever played SNK, there's a guy, a kickboxer, does Muay Thai, he does like tornadoes, like that, but with his fists instead.
His fists? Well, yeah, I guess. Like a go-ahead dashi-ish.
One thing I've always realized, Street Fighter always make it pretty common to have big feet. If you don't have big feet, you probably can't be in Street Fighter.
Well, yeah, I mean, it hurts more to get hit by a big foot than a little one, right?
Yeah, well.
Oh, that's where I get pierced or something. I have to check first.
Ouch. Ouch!
That's how we show the world.
You win.
So that was a pretty interesting experience. You do have a 75% win. I might have to play talk a little less, play a little harder maybe.
this game is just very different. It's gonna take a little time to get used to. This is definitely no Street Fighter 4. Like I learned it the hard way myself.
So they take out Gal, but they keep Vega. But I can't be too mad because I don't see Bison here either.
Well, there's another one that's missing too. Can you guess who?
Well, Faggot? I mean Saget?
Saget's another one. But then, you know, there's the absence of Akuma.
Well, Akuma did come a little bit later from the originals. Doesn't hurt that much.
Yeah, but he's been in every single Street Fighter ever after that. Every Street Fighter, including 3.
Well, I do see Bison.
He wasn't here. In 3.
Yeah, that's true. It brought the Birdie back. But shouldn't Birdie have his middle finger out constantly? I don't know.
I more remember him for like picking his nose.
Dawson feels extremely different. I'm gonna pick him.
Oh, he looks different, I can tell you that.
I guess this is before he went bald, before hairless completely.
Like grew a beard, and we can't see if he has hair in the top of his head because he has that turban. So, you know, it's an interesting new change in appearance, which I kind of welcome.
Yeah, I like it too. I think he's been hanging around Piccolo a little bit.
Probably. He stretches out, and yeah, he has the most incompetent. Look at that. It's so cool right there. I love that. And they took away Zangief from back of this, which got me a little upset. I mean, they gave him a pretty cool beat skill. Which lets him parry attacks. Right there. I guess I can check that out. He's probably right there.
Well, believe it, guys. There I try to grab, but when you're grabbing against Zangief, he's more than likely going to have the priority.
Slade.
I'm used to him stretching his arms there. He no longer stretches.
Does some kind of.
Yeah, but from the high punch from the crouching position with a high punch, he's supposed to stretch his arms in the previous Street Fighters. I guess they switched it up a bit.
Yeah, a lot of the normals were changed up. That's the same problem actually I had with Chun-Li. As you guys probably don't know, I was actually maining Chun-Li in Street Fighter 4. So when I made the transition to this game, it was like, what the fuck did they do? I was so mind blown with what they did with this game. So it was Zangief. I used Zangief and they changed a couple of things. And I was like, I mean, I still enjoy them. I think they're still very well made characters. I think they are in a good place in this game as far as balance, in my opinion anyway. But yeah, they made some major changes, and I was sick. I feel like I have to relearn this whole game. It's crazy.
I mean, with some of the changes made, I actually don't mind it. I feel like Zangief, although he can stretch his arms, the way he throws his fireball and the curved motion, almost looking like a N, works at his advantage.
Well, it gives him another advantage. It gives Dalsim another advantage over, before now. Because most people are thinking, hey, instinctively, let me jump over this fireball. Jump over this fireball. Now you got this guy where it's like, you can't jump and that's bad. And jumping is bad.
Wow.
And it's actually a good setup for his super as well, because the super, he still shoots that orb. He shoots a big fat orb that flies across the screen, like the same way as the fireball.
This guy reminds me of Uni or something, like his aggression. Uni from Street Fighter Arcade Edition, Street Fighter 4.
Oh, yeah.
I think I just spat at you. If she's beating him, I don't mind it.
Sure, I'll beat her anytime.
But I cannot ignore the fact what I'm seeing bulging in her pants, and it's very feminine what I'm seeing. They call it the camel toe.
Ouch. Apparently he doesn't like his knees.
Oh. I just think he has a different method of approaching what he likes. Some people are a little bit more barbaric in approaching women.
Yeah.
Probably dragging her by the hair afterwards and having his way. Though I don't condone it, he has a different opinion apparently.
That's how you go.
Wow. I'm sorry, but that does remind me of Felice from Darkstalkers. Quite a bit.
I can kind of see that. She did roll like a ball in that one, right?
Yes, she did.
Oh, man. That was awesome.
Thank you. I promise you guys, that was luck. I went Super Saiyan. I just knew that was the moment I had to try to guess to do the special. I didn't know that's what he was going to do, but I knew a special was coming out. And now he's going to take her and have his way with her.
Great. I guess that's what he likes.
Well, he's showing that he's advertising the merchandise right there.
Maybe into the necrophilia or something.
Well, like and subscribe, guys, on Master Samsta on YouTube, and make sure you check out Andy's channel. Please tell him.
AG Vask. You can just search me as Vask or AG Vask. It'll both ways come up. Big old V. Yeah,
leave some comments. Tell us what game you'd like to see us play next. And even if it's specials that you like to see, like move combos or whatever it may be. I mean, if I can't do, I'm sure Andy can or one of our friends can. Or we might just play enough and just do it.
All right.
Take care, guys.
Thanks for watching.